I'm in the South Island of New Zealand, and this place is simply spectacular. I'm actually on my way back from Mount Cook National Park, and it takes a little while reflecting to realise the scale and the magnitude of everything that's around you. But driving back out of here with time on my side to appreciate it, the place is astounding. There's plenty of opportunities to stop often and just breathe in your surroundings. And only 20 minutes out, this is actually my third stop. And I've recently been asked, what makes New Zealand unique? Everywhere's got mountains. But I think it's the understated way in which New Zealand does what it does. Mount Cook and the Southern Alps high up in the clouds, and even on this grey day, is epic. Now it takes ages to go anywhere in New Zealand. I've been trying to get to Wanaka. I've been trying to get Wanaka for the sunset tonight, and sunset is in about 25 minutes. And I'm nowhere close to Wanaka because I stopped to take photographs of the clay cliffs. Video and photograph this place, I need to climb another hill. This one's much smaller, I hope, than the last one I did earlier on this morning. So, over the other side, though, there's something quite beautiful. And looking out west, there is some clouds, but it's pretty light. And if that's okay, and if that's clear, I'm going to get some colour in the sky. So I'm all set up here on 6 seconds. F32, we've got some lovely white lines in the mountains here with snow-capped mountains in the background. We've got the road, we've got some tussocks in the foreground. And I'm going to run with this 6 second exposure because I don't have time to put a 10 stop on because it's going to give me 30 seconds to minute exposure. And the colour that I've got in the sky is vanishing really quick. So there's obviously some kind of cloud off to the west, but there's some lovely colours on the left hand side of the frame here that's just picking up some of the highlights on the hills. Sorry, I'm just trying to do two things at once. It's four, but I'm quite happy with the composition. I'm quite happy with the light we're getting despite there's not being colour, but we can't help that. It has been raining off and on all day today, so this is actually really nice and moody. Three, five, six, boom. I'm happy with that. That's gonna be nice. So the colour was in the wrong direction tonight, but composition sometimes is more important than colour, and sometimes vice versa. There's no right or wrong answer. But I'm going to have to get down off this mountain because there's some big meaty clouds and a cold front coming in. The wind's just picked up, so I've got about 5 minutes to get off this mountain. But here's this colour show behind me in the wrong direction tonight, so that's unfortunate, but it is what it is. I thought I'd grab the shot rather than drive past it. And sometimes photography is really hard to pull together. It's hard. But today, that's an end to a good day. And I'm going to just sit and watch this for the couple of minutes I maybe do have, because that colour is actually really strong. That's really nice. But it is very cold. And as you can see, this is rolling in behind me. So it's maybe best I watch it on the way to the car. That's what I'll do. I'll get off to the van, get the campsite, and we'll see you tomorrow. Cheerio. So I have come back up to the Wanaka tree after being here last year, and a few things are different. It's not minus five, and it's there's water in this time. Last time I was here, there was no water in the water, so in the lake, and the tree was high and dry. So just an opportunity to try and take it with some green on it in the water. There's quite a few people here this morning, so we're all vying for position, which is all good. That's what photography is all about. And there's no arguments, which is awesome. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Oh, there's 25 people. So we do have people walking in front of the camera, so that's all good. Wanaka's got to be one of the most beautiful places in New Zealand, I think. And it's backed by big mountains over the back here. Just waiting for this light to come up. Now the light's coming up quite high up, and it's just out of frame for me because I'm shooting away. 150mm today. So I'm trying to work out exposure times here, so I'm getting a natural reading of 6 seconds at f11 at 100 ISO. But I'm wanting to try and use a 10 stop. So what I'm going to have to do is I'm going to have to up the ISO, and because it takes me to about 16 minutes at f11. So if I take it back to f9 and go up to 400 ISO, that takes me back to 4 minutes, 4.5 minutes. So I'll probably set this over 4.5 minutes, and that'll allow me to smooth that water right out. But over 4 minutes, the light's going to increase, so just have to watch that I'm not going to overexpose this. So what I'm going to do is I'm just slightly underexpose it to accommodate for the rising light, which is a little bit complicated, but it's probably the only way I can do this. So I've now got half a second, so 1 second, 2, 4, 8, 15, 30, 1 minute, 2 minute, 4 minute, 8 minute, 8 minute, 4 minute, 2 minute. So 2 minutes at f9, 400 ISO is the native reading here, but at critical times of the day like now, just before the sun breaches that horizon, the available light doubles every 45 seconds or so. So I'm reducing my f-stop to f11, and I'll do 45 second exposure, which is about 1 2/3 stops under where I should be right now, but this will allow for the increasing light. And it'll still leave me half a stop under, which I can correct in post and protect my highlights.
Onto bulb.
Things change really fast during these times, so you just need to calculate quickly and alter your plan.
Put this down and get my trigger.
So no sooner has the intense light come, it's gone again, and you can see in here behind me that there is still some light there, but there's also lots and lots of people taking photographs. So that's probably the light finish there for me today, because I usually shoot in really intense light, just when you get that diffracted light before the sun reaches the horizon, the light bends and it intensifies. I'm going to wait for some of these people to go away, and I'm going to get the drone up. I might even take an unusual shot of the tree with the drone. It may have been taken before, may not. I've certainly never seen one. So the trick with these scenes here is that you've got to try and take your scene and take your shot in a way that nobody else has. It's a beautiful, beautiful part of the world, and it's well worth a visit if you're ever in New Zealand. And although this tree is well photographed,
go and photograph it as well, if you can get room. But of note, people walking in front of the cameras today, people standing in your shot just temporarily whilst you set up, but being courtesy enough to stand there, then get back out the road and let everybody to have a shot, and there's no arguments, there's no hassle. And there's a few people here today, so that's really encouraging. That's really encouraging. Probably quite a few serious photographers here this morning as well. Not just people who are taking Instagram shots or hobbyists, so a wide range, which is really cool to see. Right, get this drone up.
Now, drones are fast becoming pretty antisocial, so I always ask everyone for their permission before I fly, as they too are trying to take a photograph. And the subtle light here is simply beautiful and actually needs no words. Now, kiwis have a fantastic view on the outdoors, and they seem to have that work-play balance just so right. And what a place to do it. I'm heading to a bar for lunch where I've met Sam. Sam's about as local as I am, and he should actually be working for the tourist board. Locals always know the coolest locations they shoot.
Sam, where would we go if we wanted photographs off the beaten track?
I would recommend Glendu Bay, the Maitapu River. There's a beautiful gorge down there and it's lovely, beautiful scenic walks, and it's walks straight down onto the lake. It's gorgeous.
Awesome, thank you.
No problem. Thank you.
So always worthwhile taking locals' tips where to go, and I've taken a walk down this this gorge. It's certainly a serene, beautiful calm part of the world and well worth a trip and a good day, but I don't think it's going to work today, and also it is still raining, and my feet are soaking wet. Now, that forecasted rain has finally caught up, and I'm being pinned in here on all four sides. So it's out of Wanaka, and I'm off to Cardrona ski field to try to see if I can get above the clouds. Now, that didn't work, so I'm heading into the Cardrona Hotel. This hotel was actually sawn in half during a marital split many years ago, and this is one cool spot to spend the evening. Into the bar for some food, a coffee, and an 18-year-old Boonahabin single malt whiskey, where I'll sit and do some post-processing in front of an open fire. The next morning looked promising, for a little while at least, but New Zealand's got the habit of reminding you who's in charge, and the weather got worse and worse until I got to the east coast, where it was a little unsettled. Now, a storm front has hit, and I'm going to go to the beach anyway for a look, but without my camera. This was horrendous. There's actually an Asian girl just in front of me here wearing high heels and a short denim jacket. I just need to toughen up. I don't think there'll be any photographs tonight. Good morning, I'm down on the beach in Moaraki, and it's on the east coast of New Zealand. I tried to get down here last night, but I was actually blown off the beach because there's a storm coming from the Antarctic. So not only is this a beach which is windy, this is also a beach with a lot of people on it. Now, we've got probably about 100 people on the beach this morning. It's a really well photographed spot, this. But because there's been a storm here, there's a lot of debris being brought in from the sea. There's logs, there's trees, there's lots of sea foam, but there's also lots of seaweed everywhere as well, so it's really, really messy. Now, I had thought I would come down here and try and do a shot which was quite wide and take in the colour of the sea, but because of the number of people that are here and also just how messy the beach itself is, it's usually pristine, this beach. I'm going to have to try and get down quite low, chop that bottoms off the rocks and just catch in the horizon. But because I've got so many people here taking photographs and selfies,
I might have to slow this down to about 4 or 8 minutes, and that's going to smooth out the sea. It's going to move the clouds, but it's also going to make the people in the shot disappear over time. So I'm not sure what to think of this, to be honest. It's these are the boulders here. They're quite weird geological things. They're all big spherical rocks. Just going to reframe this and take this at about 3 minutes. Because I'm going for 3 minutes, I'm going to have to cover over the eyepiece for light leakage. So, now I have no more right to this shot than anyone else, and it's no one else's fault that I'm taking a 3 minute exposure. And I certainly can't ask nor expect anyone to stay out of shot just so I can get my shot away, so I have to do the best I can. This is actually quite a good illustration of the fusion of different disciplines of photography coexisting in a busy location. I quite like this actually, it's a bit of fun. Too many variables here for me today. There's high winds, there's high seas, lots of sea foam both on the beach and at sea, and there's very little colour. There's a storm overhead, and there's a storm just recently come in from Antarctica. So now we've got 100 people on the beach this morning, so it's probably not ideal landscape photographer's conditions, having to deal with all these components. And the tide is out as well, it's too far out. The tide was right this morning for sunrise, but it didn't come out at sunrise because it was pouring with rain, so wouldn't have had colour anyway. So we'd probably take a really nice photograph of this in the right conditions when the beach is nice and clean. Now that's me about done from Moeraki, but it's also me done, I think, from the South Island of New Zealand. I've had fun on this trip, and I hope you have as well. It's been difficult, but it's been a learning curve, so until next time, from me, cheerio.